So guys, let's continue the next disease. That is our Addison disease. So we studied about Cushing's. That was hyperfunctioning. This is hypofunctioning of adrenal cortex. Hypofunctioning. So the most recent can be 80%, it is autoimmune, but it is autoimmune. Now one of the other causes is, normally if a patient have TB for long years, TB, tuberculosis, it can lead to adrenal insufficiency. Remember, it's a very important point. Other reason, like you have any anterior pituitary problem, problem with ACTH, any problem with the pituitary gland, or in HIV patient, they will have extra pulmonary TB. This all reason can make what? Addison disease. Now the patient can be presented with the two types of symptoms. That is only it is acute. Acute symptoms include, they will have hypotension, nausea, vomiting. If you go to chronic, they will have definitely orthostatic hypotension. The other main symptom here is hyperpigmentation. Remember, hyperpigmentation in the palm, everywhere. They will have more pigment. So the mechanism is, you remember POMC, propiomelanocortin, they make melanocortin and ACTH. So if there is less ACTH from pituitary, they will produce more ACTH. Together with we will have more melanocortin. So that can make what? Hyperpigmentation. Remember it. And that's also in Addison, we have less functioning. So in the blood, we will have less sodium, right? Sodium will be less reabsorbed and more potassium. Other thing here, remember in acute also, can remember coma, patient can have sudden coma. So these are the two presentation, acute and chronic presentation of what? Addison disease. Now we have to see the diagnosis or differential diagnosis, how to confirm this. Now like in Cushing syndrome, what we do is, if the patient comes with the signs and symptoms, we have to confirm it, is it Addison disease itself. So if they comes with the signs and symptoms, what we do is, first we will do cortisol test, level of cortisol. It's called at the AM, 9 AM in the morning. If cortisol is not suppressed, it's normal, no problem. Because it is not adrenal insufficiency. But if cortisol is decreased or suppressed, we are talking about adrenal insufficiency. So once again, so to confirm, or the patient comes with these symptoms, first we'll do the cortisol morning test, and if the cortisol is less, it means what? There is adrenal insufficiency. So adrenal insufficiency means it can be Addison's disease, right? We confirm it is Addison's dysfunction. Now, next thing we'll do is, we'll go for corticotropin stimulation test. Corticotropin stimulation. That is ACTH. So if you do corticotropin stimulation, and if you see increase in salt or increase in mineral of aldosterone or the hormones from cortex, it means problem is in the anterior pituitary. Right. So the problem is in the anterior pituitary. But if you don't see any change, the problem is in the adrenal gland itself. If you don't see any change after inducing corticotropin, the problem is not in the pituitary, the problem is in your adrenal gland. So both cases we have to do CT or MRI and will give cortisol for treating him. Here also we do MRI scanning of adrenal gland. Here also we have to inject what? Cortisol. So the problem, the differentiation we are doing is that a problem with the pituitary or the problem is with what? Adrenal gland. See, there is a better drug that is asked in every exam. In this adrenal insufficiency or problem in the adrenal gland, we give a drug. It is called flutricortisone. Flutricortisone. So steroid drug that we give for what? Addison disease. The problem is with what? Adrenal gland. Okay. Now, some other reason can also make adrenal insufficiency. That is, if you are a chronic steroid drug user. So once again, I am repeating here. First, if the patient comes with signs and symptoms, we'll check the cortisol AM. It is no change, it is normal, no addition. It is decreased, means adrenal insufficiency. So that means he is having Addison disease. Now Addison, we have to know it is from pituitary problem or adrenal gland. So we do a test called corticotropin stimulation. So it is increased in, after stimulating, if the mineralocorticoids or steroids increased, it means the problems in the adrenal pituitary. So we do CT or MRI pituitary and it will confirm and it will give what? Cortisol. There is no change after giving corticotropin, it means the problem is where? The adrenal gland. So we do MRI or we can do CT also here, CT scan. And we give cortisol. And what is the drug we give? Flutricortisone. Clear? Now, there is a very important question. This corticotropin stimulation test we done for ACTH or Addison disease, that is called cosinropin test. There is a question, board question. The test used for corticotropin stimulation, that is called cosinropin test. We use for finding the level of what? AC. The problem is in the pituitary or adrenal. So that test is having a name that is called cosinropin test. Now some other things, remember, some other things can make shutdown of adrenal gland. That is, if you are a chronic steroid user, chronic glucocorticoid or steroid drug user, can make adrenal insufficiency. Adrenal insufficiency, because chronic drug steroid user, they will inhibit ACTH release, because we have enough steroid in the glucocorticoids in the blood, so body will think no, pituitary will think no need of ACTH, so it can cause adrenal insufficiency or adrenal shutdown. So this can be also the reason. So I think I have given all the important point about Addison disease. So these are the main thing we are remember, hypofunctioning. So how you differentiate the test, the name of test, cosinropin drug name, fluticortisone, the other thing. So remember, in adrenal insufficiency, we'll have problem. We cannot have salt and sugar mainly. No aldosterone, that is less sodium, more potassium we'll have, and steroid, so glucose problem. Okay, so that's all about Addison disease. Next, we'll move to Cone syndrome in the next video.